Good morning to you. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you? Now, today, I have two masks. Let me take it. So I was told that you ended on the business ethics.
Business ethics.
I want us to note that this is topic one. Just remind ourselves of what we had covered, the topics. We have got a total of 15 topics. We have topic one. It's called introduction. Then entrepreneur. Then we have business ideas. The other one is called business opportunities. Then we have gender and then entrepreneurship. Then you have social end, social entrepreneurship. Then you have what you call small and medium enterprises, commonly known as SMEs. Now, this is what we have for senior five. So senior five, you have a total of seven topics. Now, usually in senior six, we start from, I hope you can see from here. We start from what you call business planning. Business planning. Then we have, so there are a total of 15 topics. Then we have production, management. Then we have sales promotion. We have sales promotions. We have marketing management. Management. Then we have HRM. This is human resource management. Sometimes they call it personnel management. Then we have financial management. Two more. Then we have competition. Business competition. Then finally we have capital markets. Now in senior six, we're supposed to begin from here. This is what is designated for senior five. And this is senior what? Senior six. Now, usually, why I've done this, we need to know why we should have all the topics. Now, in most cases in entrepreneurship, not in most cases, but always, when they are setting entrepreneurship, they will set a number from a given topic. We shall not have two numbers from one topic. So for example, when they say question number two in paper one, is coming from topic two. I'm just saying, for instance, question number three cannot come from the same topic. It will be a different topic. So we need to know all the topics and then be able to prepare very well. Now, I want us to note one thing. That we often get confused when it comes to topic one. Now, topic one is the widest topic. Why? Topic one is the widest topic. Can you be able to see me?
Yes, teacher.
Now,
we can see you.
So topic one is the widest topic. And it's called introduction. I don't want you to be confused. So here it has all those definitions. What do you want? That's what I said. Topic one has those definitions of those keywords. For example, entrepreneurship, enterprising person, entrepreneur, and all that. Moving down to things like risks, not a change, creativity, entrepreneur motivation, innovation, negotiation, risks, communication, business ethics, personal branding. All this is topic one. So when they are setting a paper, a UNEP paper, or a standard paper, we are saying that all these, as we are reading from all these communications, all these are written. We are preparing for one question. Because we have said they cannot set two numbers from a given topic. So every topic will produce a single number. So therefore, as I'm reading all this, the senior fine work, the whole of what you have right now, that is still topic what? One. So meaning I am still preparing for a single number. I hope you get that. Now, that's what I wanted to emphasize. Now, I want you to have the books, the notes that you have, that was given to you by the school. I want us to make, for those that have the book near there, I want you to turn to communication. There is somewhere where you have communication. Communication, according to this book, is starting from page 63. Okay, yes, page 62. I want you to realize that that all work communication is under topic one. It's not standing on its own. That was an error. That was a typing error. Not typing, but maybe there was an error in trying to bind the work. So the whole of that work communication goes, it is part of topic one. Our topic one is called introduction. So whatever we are reading, a topic, for example, topic one, and I want to exhaust it, I should know that communication is part of that. It's not a topic on its own. I hope you have noted that. Have you noted that? Yes. Now, it means we are supposed to cover, because we've said we have 15 topics. So far we are on our first topic, which is the introduction, which we are yet to complete. It means we still have 14 topics untouched. Meaning we need to work very hard. We need to get committed such that we can run quite faster. Otherwise, we may We may not finish what we are supposed to do if we don't move very fast. So we need to note that. So therefore, today, it means in topic one, we are left with personal branding. We are left with communication. We finish topic one. Today, I am not going to talk about that. I want to move straight away to topic two. We shall get time to complete that. I want us to widen our scope of touching on different topics, such that it gives us more chances of answering quite a number of questions. So we are going to move to topic two today. Topic two. Now, topic two is called entrepreneurial environment. That's what you're going to go through now. Now, according to your book here, entrepreneurial environment is on which page? Because we are trying to follow the same notes since you have the notes. Which page is it? Which page?
Yeah, I don't know. Don't ask me.
Okay, let me join the sign. All right, let me check here.
Hello? Can you guys hear me? Come in, I tell you about the telephone. I don't know what you're for.
We can hear you.
Yeah. All right, let's now continue. So I'm saying that today we're going to start on this topic two, and we are going to move a little faster. I do not want you to complain or like to be discouraged or to think like, oh my God, we are just on topic one. The reason is very clear that you've been on and off because of Corona. You're being quite on and off. And I think that is the reason why we are behind. But we can still make it the moment we get committed, and then we move on as planned. So we just need to remain positive and know that you can do it. Please do not be discouraged. All right? All right. Now, I'm saying that we're going to start on this topic. Now, entrepreneur environment, we are supposed to look at the definition. We are supposed to look at the characteristics. We are supposed to look at the types of entrepreneur environment. We are supposed to look at how each of these will affect the level of entrepreneurship, how each of the type will affect the level of entrepreneurship, what? So basically, that's what you're supposed to look at. Definition of entrepreneur environment, characteristics, the types, how each of these types will affect the level of entrepreneurship development. Now, entrepreneur environment refers to the combination of organic and inorganic forces or integration that will have an impact on the business startup process by an entrepreneur. What I mean is this. When we talk of entrepreneur environment, we do not mean man and his environment. Man and his what? Environment. What you did in a primary, no. We don't mean that. We simply mean the conditions under which businesses can be started, the circumstances under which businesses can start. That's what we mean by entrepreneur environment. I can give you an example. That today, for example, if you are studying, you're in class, but there's a lot of noise around where you are studying from. We are likely to say that the learning environment is unconducive, or the learning environment is unfavorable. We have always said that, meaning that the conditions, the circumstances under which the learning is taking place is not favorable. We are saying the same thing here. The entrepreneur environment, you're looking at the circumstances, the conditions under which businesses can be started. These conditions can be good. These conditions can be bad. Now, when the conditions are good, we shall call it favorable environment. When the conditions are bad, we shall call them unfavorable conditions. So that is what you mean by entrepreneur environment. Now, we have finished this, the definition. Let's go to the characteristics. Now, we want to know the characteristics of entrepreneur environment. The characteristics, in most cases, when you say characteristics in this paper, this is the same as the features. We may also call them the traits. All of these will mean the same thing, depending on what I want to use. If I decide to say characteristics, another teacher uses the word features, another uses traits, it is just the same thing. It's like saying perfect, crisp. I'm still talking of the same word, the same person. So whether I decide to use the word features, the characteristics, the traits, it's the same. And in most cases, we are going to use different words to refer to the same thing. So we need to know how different words will mean the same. So I'm saying the characteristics of the entrepreneur environment is looking at how does the entrepreneur environment behave? What characterizes, what defines the entrepreneur environment? So the characteristics are, we have what you call resource scarcity. You have it there. Then you have uncertainty. Please, this is the spelling of uncertainty. I have seen in your book, on the book you have, uncertainty was written like this. Uncertainty. this spelling is not correct. I think that this is not correct. This I is not supposed to be there because this is a key word. The moment you miss out on the spelling, the point is marked wrong. So uncertainty, then you have opportunity, orientation, opportunity, orientation. Okay. And first we have flexibility. These are the four characteristics of an entrepreneur environment. They're right there. The four characteristics of an entrepreneur environment. Now, when you are explaining, just identify the points like I've done, full stop, then you give the explanation. Like that. So scarce resources means when something is scarce, it means it's not enough, okay? It is limited. So we just say the entrepreneur environment is characterized by limited resources that are not enough. What are those resources? We are looking at the resources that you need to start a business. For example, land, money, labor, machinery. These are the resources we are needing. That usually when you want such a business, these resources are not enough. So resources are what? Limited. Uncertainty. Now, uncertainty simply means that you are not sure of something. What do I mean? If you're doing a business, in most cases, you may not be sure whether you're going to make profits or not. If you're just starting. You may not also be sure whether the business is going to succeed or not. So that's what we are saying, there is the uncertainty. So in simply say, the entrepreneur environment is characterized with or by unknowns. Characterized by unknowns, such as uncertain profits, unexpected risks, unexpected business failure or success. That's what we mean by uncertainty. Then opportunity orientation. This simply means that within the entrepreneur environment, there are so many opportunities that you can take on to begin a business. For example, if you are given money today, you can think of even 20 types of businesses, meaning that there are so many opportunities that exist within the entrepreneur environment. So we simply say the entrepreneur environment is characterized by many opportunities that one can take on to begin a business. Flexibility. The opportunities that are presented within the entrepreneur environment are not permanent. They are flexible. Today you can have an opportunity to start a business, but the moment you delay, that opportunity will go because another person can take on the opportunity. So within the entrepreneur environment, there is a lot of opportunities that keep on changing, that are flexible, they come and go. So those are the characteristics of the entrepreneur environment. Please follow your notes. Let's follow the notes. Then we go to the types. Types of entrepreneur environment. Types of entrepreneur environment. Now we have basically five types of entrepreneur environment at your level. If you go to the university, then they will, and you are still studying business, then they might have to increase. At this level, we have five. So we have what you call economic environment. We have political. Environment, political environment. We have demographic environment. Then we have social cultural environment. And lastly, global environment. Those are the types. So we said that we are supposed to look at how each of these will have an impact in the process of starting up a business. I want to give you an example. If the economic environment is good, and therefore it is favorable, it's going to attract so many people to come and start up businesses. For example, if the roads are good, people have got the money, the customers are there, you know, economic, there's what we call good or favorable economic policies. All those will actually favor the business startup process. It will attract so many people to come and venture into business. But when such things are not good, there is scarcity of money, the roads are bad, they are going to negatively impact on the process of starting up a business. So just like I was explaining that each of these will have a way how they are going to affect the process of starting up a business. So the economic environment is about the economics. That these are the conditions within the economics. When we say the economic environment is there, the conditions under which businesses are going to start it. Business, and businesses can be started. So the economic conditions are the conditions, the economic environment rather, are the conditions under that relate to the economics of the country and how they are going to affect. The economic conditions, they are referring to things like roads, the money, the markets. You know, if they are really perfect, then they are going to favor the business. If they are not, they are going to limit. The political conditions is to do with the governance of the country, the policies of the government. How are they? Those are the conditions we call political environment. If the policies of the government are good, for example, the government is giving people free loans, the government is charging low taxes, those conditions are going to favor the businesses. If they are bad, then the businesses are going to be discouraged. Then there's what's called demographic. Environment. Demographic, this word here comes from the word demography. Demography is population. So therefore the demographic environment are the conditions that relate to the population and how they are going to affect the business startup process. I want to give you an example. That if the population is very high in a given place, then we are likely to have large markets that is going to prompt or preempt many people to venture into business. And as many people come into business, we have entrepreneurship growing or developing. Then sociocultural factors. We also have those conditions that relate to the cultures of the community. For example, religion. You cannot be able to sell goods in a Muslim community. That already is. Those are the conditions that create the social-cultural environment. Then global environment. These are the conditions that relate to the international world. Globally, what is done in Kenya? What is done in other countries, in China, in Europe, will obviously affect how we do business here back home. For example, if there is inflation everywhere, it will affect us. So the global environment, we're looking at the global, the international conditions. What happens elsewhere in the world? Those are the conditions called in the global environment. I said that you're going to look at each of these and how they affect entrepreneurship development. Let's start with the economic environment. Economic environment. So we say economic factors that determine the level of and the level of entrepreneurship, the level of entrepreneurship development. Economic factors that determine the level of entrepreneurship development. Now, this word determine can be replaced. I can say determine is the same as affect. Or determine is the same as influence. Influence. So therefore, we can have economic factors that influence the level of entrepreneurship development. Economic factors that affect the levels of entrepreneurship development. Or economic factors that determine. Are we following? Guys, are you following? Are we together? Are we there? Oh.